Good morning, students. So we will continue with decision tree. So in decision trees, we started with ID3 followed by C4.5. So to continue with, we will see Gini index or CART, which is the another type of your decision tree. So your Gini index is also called as CART. So let me share. So we'll continue with Gini index in today's class. So Gini index is one more technique of decision tree. It is also called as CART. It was developed by IBM. It is also said to be IBM Intelligent Miner. So this type of decision tree is sophisticated when compared to all the other techniques that we have dealt. So till now we started with ID3 and your gain ratio. So the third method is Gini index. So in Gini index, the approach is as follows. So given a data set consisting of say n classes, Gini index can be calculated by using the following formula. So it is 1 minus summation of j is equal to 1 to n of probability square. Here pj stands for probability of each class label or each tuple in your data set. So have a note of this. So Gini index can be calculated by 1 minus summation of 1 to n of probability square. Check whether you have followed. So this is one more method where pj is called as your probability, or it can also be termed as relative frequency of class j in data set D. Similarly, your data set can be split into say two subsets, D1 and D2. So if you divide, assume that you are dividing your data set into two subsets, D1 and D2, Gini index of each of the subset can be calculated as follows. So D1 is the subset 1 divided by total data set into Gini index of D1. Similarly, D2 is the another subset divided by the total tuples in the data set D into Gini index of D2. So once you find Gini index of data set with respect to the split A, so the difference in the delta is nothing but it is termed as difference. So delta is the difference of the Gini index of split A. This can be calculated as Gini index of the total data set subtracted by Gini index of data set with respect to the attribute A. So the attribute provides the smallest split. So if this value, whatever value you get, if this is less, it means that the impurity is less. If there is a huge data or huge value that you get after calculating your delta Gini index or change in the Gini index, then it says, okay, this consists of most of the information required for our decision tree. So it can be your possible splitting point. So the Gini index has to be calculated for each attribute, and whichever as the lowest value will be taken. So attribute which provides the lowest Gini index can be taken as the split, because the impurity is less and there is a larger possibility of reducing or splitting your attribute into further attributes so that it can be dealt in a different way. So as of now, you copy all this formulas. So how to calculate the Gini index of the total system, Gini index of a particular attribute A, where data set will be divided into two subsets, D1 and D2, and how to reduce your impurity. Here, your delta Gini is nothing but that is your impurity. So have a note of this. So this is a brief introduction of your Gini index. So we will take the same data set example and check how to apply Gini index to the following data set, that is your play tennis data set. So here, if we know how to calculate entropy already, so finding the number of yes, number of no will give you the entropy. So now, once you have calculated entropy, we have to check Gini index for each of the attribute. What is the Gini index of outlook, temperature, humidity, wind, and whichever gives the lowest value of the Gini index factor, that is selected as the root node. So if we consider outlook, that is the first attribute in the data set. Outlook is a nominal feature and it can take three values. So it can, the attributes or the values of the attribute outlook can be sunny, overcast or rain, right? So if we summarize the decision of the outlook here, you have to check what is the values which are yes and values which are no, and categorize them into sunny, overcast and rain. So go back. So here consider only sunny values for your outlook. So there are five values. Out of this five values, how many are yes and how many are no? So three are no and two are yes, right? So have a note of it. So for the value sunny of outlook attribute, two have decision label as yes and three as no. What is the total number of instances which are of sunny? So there are five. Similarly, for overcast, number of yes is four and number of no is zero. So for overcast, number of yes as decision label is 4, as we can see, and there is no label with decision no for overcast. So for overcast, there are 4 as decision label and 0 no, and number of instances are 4. Similarly, if you consider rain, there are 3 yes, 2 no's, total 5. So if you add all this, so the total number of instances are 14. So out of 14, 5 are sunny, 4 are overcast, and 5 are rain. Which are the values that your outlook can take? So here you have yes and no labels. So Gini index is calculated by its probability, right? So out of 5 values or 5 instances, 2 of them are yes, 3 of them are no. So if I want to calculate Gini index for outlook, where outlook is sunny, this is nothing but what is the probability of yes? Probability of yes would be 2/5. Similarly, probability of no will be 3/5. So this can be calculated by applying it to the first formula that we have discussed, that is 1 minus the probability square. So your probability can be yes and no. So two values should be considered. So this can be calculated as 2/5 square minus 3/5 square. So this turns out to be the value 0.48. Similarly, if I consider outlook is equal to overcast, then there are only labels which are yes, right? For overcast, which is an value of outlook, if you have a label, there are only yes labels. So your Gini index value will be 0. Similarly, for rain, there are 3 yes, 2 no attributes. So this is 1 minus 3/5 square minus 2/5 square, which is equal to 0.48. So now we have calculated the Gini index of your subsets, that is Gini index of sunny, Gini index of overcast, and Gini index of rain. So to calculate the overall Gini index for the feature outlook, we will consider the weighted sum of Gini index along with their probabilities. So the final outcome or the Gini index value of your outlook can be calculated as 5 on 14 instances where sunny with the probability 0.48 plus 4 on 14 instances of overcast. So it is 4/14. And what is the Gini index of overcast? It is 0. Similarly, 5/14 into 0.48. So if you sum up everything, the value turned out to be 0.342. So similarly, can you find out what can be the Gini index of the decision? For this, how will you find out the Gini index? So how many S labels are there? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 and 6. So what will be the Gini index of play tennis? Compute and say the answer. So it is 1 minus what are S? 8/14 square minus 6/14 square. So what will be the value? The overall Gini index value of play tennis is? What is the value? Calculate and share the result. Guys, you are able to follow? Yeah, then calculate and say what is the answer for play tennis? Yeah, 0.48 or 0.489, correct? So That is the Gini index, the total Gini index of your class level plate tennis is 0.48. So once you have calculated Gini index of outlook, you will also calculate for temperature. So for temperature, it is also a nominal feature. It can take three different values, cool, hot and mild. So again, check the data set, how many S labels of hot are there, no are there, and what is the total number of instances, and what is the values for cool, which is an value of attribute temperature, similarly mild. So in this table, you have gathered information regarding how many values of S are there and how many values of no are there. How will you find this? You will find the decision variable. So in this example, decision variable is plate tennis. So for temperature with value hot, you will check how many decision variables are S. Similarly, how many decision variables are no, and the total number of instances. So it is 4 with value hot, 4 with cool, and 6 with value mild. So again, you will find out, apply it to the formula of Gini index. So it is, what is the probability? Probability of hot when the sub attribute or sub data set is S is 2/4. Similarly for no, it is 2/4. So what will be the probability? Equal probability, so it is 0.5. Similarly for temperature with value cool, probability is 3/4 and 1/4. 3/4 for value yes, 1/4 for value no. So if you apply it to the Gini index, it is 1 - 3/4² - 1/4² which will be around 0.375. Similarly, apply it for mild. So for mild, the number of S values are 4, no values are 2. Probability would be 4/6 for S, 2/6 for no. So if you apply this to your basic formula of finding your Gini index, it would be 1 - 4/6² - 2/6² which is 0.445. This is the value for Gini index of each of the value for attribute. But how will you find out the Gini index of the attribute temperature? By using again weight sum of Gini index or weighted sum of Gini index. So the weighted sum of Gini index for the attribute temperature would be calculated as 4/14 into whatever value you have got here. So it is 4/14 of 0.5 plus 4/14 of 0.375 plus 6/14 of 0.445. So the Gini index of temperature is 0.439. Similarly, find out for humidity. So humidity can take only two values, that is high and normal. So there are three labels with yes, four with no for value I. Similarly, for value normal, there are 6 yes labels and 1 no label. So the total number of instances of high are 7. Total number of instances with value normal is 7. So the Gini index is calculated as 3/7, right? The probability of S is 3/7 and probability of no is 4/7 for I. So now calculate the Gini index when humidity is equal to I, which is equal to 1 - 3/7² - 4/7², where the value is 0.489. Similarly, if you check the probability of S when the value was normal is 6. So what will be the probability? 6/7. Similarly for no, the probability would be 1/7. That is, out of 7 instances, 6 instances are true and 1 instance is false. So based upon this, calculate the Gini index of humidity is equal to normal. So this will be the value. So once I find out Gini index of each of the values in the attribute, I'll go ahead and calculate the weighted sum where the attribute is humidity. So 7/14 into 0.489 plus 7/14 into 0.244. So the total Gini index value for humidity is 0.367. For wind, again wind can take, it's a binary attribute, so binary valued attribute, sorry. So it has two types of values, that is weak and strong. So again you will compare your wind column with the plate NS table and or plate NS column and check how many values are yes and how many values are no. Here for instance weak, 6 are yes, 2 are no. Similarly for strong, 3 are yes and 3 are no. So how many instances of wind are weak? 8 instances are weak. Similarly 6 instances are strong. So what is the probability of yes? It is 6/8. Similarly probability of no is 2/8. For strong it is equal probability, 3/6, 3/6. So if you have equal number of yes and no, there is no need of finding your Gini index. So if there are equal number of positive as well as negative samples in your tuple, the Gini index value will be always 0.5. You can note this. So if number of yes and number of no labels are equal, then the Gini index value will be always equal to 0.5 because it is equiprobable. What do you mean by equiprobable? Both of them have equal probability. So the highest value of probability will be 1. Because it is equiprobable, your Gini index value will be equal to 0.5. So now to summarize, we have calculated Gini index for each of the feature, right? So Gini index of outlook is 0.342. Similarly for temperature, it is 0.439. For humidity, it is around 0.3. For wind, it is 0.4. So which one you have to take? Which one is the least? The least value here is 0.342, which belongs to the feature outlook. Yeah, here one thing that you have to notice, whereas in your ID3, that is your information gain and gain ratio, you used to take the highest value as root node, whereas in Gini index, because you are taking probability as your your formula to calculate your indexes, you will take the least value. That is the difference between your ID3 and C4.5. In CART or your Gini index, you will take the lowest value as the root node. So here, out of the values, this is the lowest value, right? 0.342 is the lowest value. Hence, your outlook will be your root node. I hope you are able to follow till here. Any doubts? So it's very simple. You have to check and count the number of yes value and no valued attribute with respect to the decision tuple or decision variable. In our case, decision variable is plate NS. So each feature will be compared with the plate NS column and you will make a note of number of yes and number of no and also the total number of attribute for a particular value or a specific value. Then you will go ahead, find its probability. Once you have got probability, what you can do, you can simply apply to the formula and find out its Gini index value. Once you have Gini index value of all features, you will consider the lowest value of Gini index as the root node. So check here. So Outlook will be your root node. Your Outlook can take three values, that is sunny, overcast and rain. So here again, if you check overcast, the decision is clear here, which is yes. So directly you can write yes here. No need to further check because this is having purity one. So what do you mean by purity one? If you are able to decide clearly without any ambiguity or confusions, you can say this particular attribute is pure. So here, because decision is clearly yes, there is no impurity involved in this particular rows of your data set. So directly for Outlook is equal to overcast, you can say yes. But for sunny and rain, you can see there are values with yes and no. So further, what you have to do, you have to consider two attributes now. So we'll see. So this can be written as yes. So next we will consider only sunny. See here. So take out the tuples which are only sunny, where Outlook value is sunny. So you will get around 5 entries with temperature, humidity, wind and decision. From this it is clearly evident that there are 3 node decisions or 2 decisions with value yes. So Outlook is sunny. So now we have to check sunny with respect to temperature, sunny with respect to humidity and sunny with respect to wind, right? Because this is already your leftmost subtree, right? So to continue with, now you will take temperature. So now we are considering only this particular table, not the original table. Whenever the Outlook is sunny, you are considering only the temperature table. In the temperature table, you have how many values? You have 3 values. So in your table, you have to write, this is the table for temperature with respect to Outlook is equal to sunny. So the decision of hot is 2, mild is 1 no, 1 no and 1 yes. For cool it is yes. So you will write temperature, all 3 values, yes and no. So from this particular table, how many attribute as no, hot as only no with no yes. So 0, 2. Similarly for cool, you had only 1 entry with decision yes. So 1, 0. For mild, you had 2 tuples with 1 decision as yes, 1 decision as no. So if you add this, you have to get 5, right? Because in the previous slide, that is whenever the Outlook was sunny, we got only 5 tuples. So out of this 5 tuples, you will repeat the process again. So see here, Gini index when Outlook is equal to sunny and temperature is equal to hot. So find the probability. So it is 0 by 2, 2 by 2. So what is your final Gini index? 0. Similarly, when Outlook was sunny, temperature was cool, your Gini index is 0. Outlook was sunny, temperature is mild, your Gini index is 0.5. See again, whenever the number of values in your yes and no are equal, there is no need to calculate. Directly you can say it as 0.5. So these are for each of the value of attribute temperature, but you have to find out the Gini index of temperature with respect to Outlook. So in order to do this, again you will apply weighted sum. So 2 by 5, see, 2 out of 5 with the entropy value 0 plus 1 out of 5 with entropy value 0, 2 by 5 with entropy value 0.5. So 0.2 will be your total gini index value when outlook is sunny, and you consider which attribute? Temperature. Similarly, for humidity, you will consider table with only sunny, same table, and you will check how many of them has humidity. So what we did, we are doing all other operations of outlook is equal to sunny by considering this table, not your original data set. Out of this, humidity has two values, high and normal. See here, if you check humidity S is equal to 0, humidity with I with the value no is 3. Similarly, for normal, the number of S labels are 2, the number of no labels are 0. So for I it is 0, 3, for normal it is 2, 0, right? See here, how many of them were S? 0, all the 3 I labels were no. Similarly, for normal, both the labels were S, and for no, it was 0. So the number of instances is 5. Again, go ahead, substitute. So probability of S is 0 by 3. Probability of no is 3 by 3. That is 1. So 1 minus 1 would be 0. Similarly, here, 2 by 2, 1 minus 1 would be 0. See here, humidity is 0. Similarly, for wind, there are 1 S label where wind value was weak, 2 no labels when wind value was weak. Similarly, 1 for strong with decision yes, 1 for strong with decision no. So if you calculate the probability, it would be 1 by 3 as yes, 2 by 3 as no. Similarly, for strong, it is 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So here, I'll go ahead and substitute the values. So when I substitute, I'll get 0.266.2. So the weighted sum will be 3 by 5 of 0.266 plus 2 by 5 of 0.2, which is 0.466. So now we have calculated the Gini index of outlook is equal to sunny with respect to all the other attributes. So see here, so these are the attributes or features, that is temperature, humidity, wind, and 0.2, 0, and 0.46. Which has lowest here? Which is lowest? 0, right? So humidity is the lowest value of your Gini index. So now we have decided whenever your outlook is sunny, the next node would be humidity. Why? Because the Gini index value is 0. So for outlook is equal to sunny, you will append one more node, humidity, with the value I and normal. See here, now if you check the decision, it is clearly distinguishable. That is, your label S and no are divided without any ambiguity. So you can stop here. So whenever humidity is high, you will say no. Whenever humidity is normal, you will say yes. So this will be your decision tree now. So outlook was overcast. For sunny, we have calculated, and Gini index of humidity was 0. This is the least Gini index, and this clearly distinguished between the values I and normal as no and S. Similarly, now for rain, for outlook rain, you will take only this particular table. Yeah. See here, for outlook, when the value was rain, you have identified this table. Now, again, you have to do it with respect to temperature, with respect to humidity is not required because it is already taken up. So, outlook with respect to temperature, outlook with respect to wind has to be calculated now. Yeah, calculate. Go ahead and calculate now. So how many values you have or how many tuples you have? You have 5 tuples, right? So for temperature, again, you have 2 values, mild and cool. How many of them are S? See, for mild, if you write in a tabular format, temperature, mild, the number of S for mild is 2 and number of no is 1. So it is 2-1. 2-1 and total number of instances is 3. Right? Similarly, for cool, 1 for S, 1 for no and total number of instances is 2. So what will be your Gini index of temperature? Calculate, and parallelly, if anyone has any doubt regarding whatever we have discussed till here, you can go ahead and ask. The rest of you calculate and share the answer. What would be your Gini index when outlook is equal to rain and temperature? Don't calculate it for humidity because already humidity is taken up by outlook is equal to sunny. So no need to consider this particular column. So out of temperature and wind, now we have to decide which would be your rightmost node in your decision tree. You're able to calculate. Yeah, please calculate and say the answer so that I can check whether you are able to follow or not. So what is the Gini index of outlook is rain and temperature is mild? Mild again is 0.44. Okay. Now calculate outlook is rain and temperature is cool. Yeah, 0. Because it was 1 for yes, 1 for no. So the probability would be 0.5, not 0. 0.5, right? So 1 minus 0.5 would be 0.5. Yeah, Krishna Street is correct. 0.44 and 0.5. So now you go ahead and apply. Why should we take temperature after outlook? You can take anything according to the attribute here from the table. It is temperature. So we have taken temperature. It is not compulsory or ardent past rule to take temperature always because your attributes are arranged in this manner. We are taking it. Otherwise, you can take any attribute and check out whichever has lowest Gini index and apply that. You have taken temperature because after outlook it is temperature. Yeah, Yuvraj, correct. 1 minus 0.5 for your outlook is rain and temperature is cool. So the answer would be 0.5. So what is the final answer? So the final answer would be 0.466, as most of you have got it right. So for the temperature, S is 1 and 1. So 1 and 1, what will be your probability? 0.5. So 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5 for your temperature is equal to cool. Similarly, for temperature is equal to mild, it is 1 by 3 whole square subtracted by 1, which is 0.44. So if you find out weighted sum, you have to take it as 2 by 5 into 0.5 plus 3 by 5 into 0.444, which is 0.466. Okay. So this is the Gini index when outlook is rain and temperature. So next humidity, there is no need to take, but if in case you want to show the all these steps, you can take, not a problem. Next, for wind, there are three weak attributes, zero no attribute, and total number of instances are 3. For strong, 0, 2. So you will apply the same method and you verify whether you will get the same answer. Yeah, so the answer would be 0, right? So now if you use it in a tabular format, once you have calculated, so you have temperature, humidity, wind. Here you have also calculated humidity, but humidity is already taken up, so there is no need to again calculate for humidity. Out of temperature and wind, if you find whichever is having lowest Gini index value, so the lowest Gini index value is for wind. So the next node for outlook is equal to rain would be wind, because it has the lowest Gini index. So when outlook is rain, you will take up wind. So wind can have two values, weak and strong. So now if you check here whether this has to be subdivided, no, because your decision is clear. So it is clearly determined yes and no, right? Which is the basic principle of your decision tree is, until and unless your decisions are determined or divided, you will go on splitting that particular attribute. Once the decision is clear, you will stop. That is your stopping criteria for decision tree. So according to the rule of decision tree, you have clearly divided the number of yes and number of no. So I'll stop here saying, whenever the outlook is rain and wind is weak, decision is yes. Similarly, whenever outlook is rain and wind is strong, decision is no. So we can complete our decision tree by saying yes. So outlook at the lowest Gini index, so I took it as the root node. So outlook can take three values, sunny, overcast and rain. So if we see overcast, all of them were having the decision yes. So it is clearly decided what would be the value. So it is determined. So in this case, whenever outlook was overcast, the answer is yes. Similarly, when you consider sunny, what we did, with respect to sunny, you calculated all other three attributes, that is humidity, temperature and wind, and humidity got the lowest Gini index. So I took humidity as the next node. So once you have got humidity, again you will go to its feature and check whether it is clearly distinguished without any ambiguity. In our case, it was distinguished. So I'll stop humidity here and I will go ahead with another attribute of outlook, which is rain. So I will take the tuples whenever the outlook value was rain. So for rain, again, I will consider which all column, temperature and wind, because humidity is already taken up here. So there is no need to calculate again for humidity. It is not a problem if you calculate also, but to be quick, what you can do is you can eliminate humidity, because humidity is already taken up in the outlook is equal to sunny. This attribute cannot come again here, right? So there is no need to calculate for humidity whenever you are considering for rain. So when you considered outlook is rain with the attribute temperature and wind, you got wind as the answer because the Gini index of wind was low. So again, if you go to that particular decision, you will check whether the decision is clearly distinguishable. In this case, yes, it is distinguishable. So this will be the stopping criteria where I'll stop my decision tree. So now you may get the comparison. What is the difference between your Gini index and ID tree? The decision tree is same. So only in this case, for this particular data set, we have got the decision tree as same, but it need not be case for each of the data set, it can differ. So in our example, for this particular data set, whether you apply ID3 or your C4.5 or your Gini index, the decision tree got the same by a luck factor. But for each of them, the decision tree would be different. Whenever you get the decision tree for ID3, that decision tree would be different from your C4.5 and your CART. But for this particular example, all the decision tree that you get is same. So this is about your CART algorithm, or it can also be termed as Gini index or IBM intelligent miner. So I hope you are able to follow what is Gini index and how to find probability of each attribute and how to apply it to the formula of Gini index. So any doubts? So for this we will take only, we'll apply Gini index and find out only which will be the root node. Only for this particular example, go ahead and find which will be your root node. Only find out which will be your root node. Okay, then take this as assignment. You have to just find out which is the root node for this particular data set. So we'll continue. So we have discussed many measures of node impurity. One of them was Gini index and entropy. See, based upon entropy, we have two methods, that is your ID3 and C4.5 were based upon entropy, whereas Gini index is based upon the Gini value that you calculate. Okay, so there are two measures of node impurity, Gini index and entropy. What is misclassification error? This we have already discussed. So your misclassification error or the error rate should be always nearer to zero. Then only you can say the accuracy of your classification is high. Otherwise, if the error rate, if it is equal to 1, that is, if you get the max of probability as 0, it means that whatever you have classified is wrong. So this you can note, these are the measures of node impurity. So basically there are only two types, Gini index and entropy. Based upon entropy, you have two methods, ID3 and C4.5. Based upon Gini index, you have CART. So misclassification error is used to check how well you can classify it, and misclassification error also helps us to find accuracy of the classification. So if you compare all the criteria together, this is for a binary problem, binary value attribute problem, or a two class problem. What do you mean by two class problem? Your decision variable will be having only two classes, like either yes or no or true or false. So if you compare all these three methods, the entropy method will be best suited for your two value or bivalued data set. Entropy, it is proved that entropy will be highest. So you can apply entropy method whenever your decision variable is binary valued, or if you have two values, only two values in your decision variable, it is better to apply entropy method. That is, either you can use ID3 or, which is the other one, C4.5. But your Gini index proves well for multi-valued attribute. So in your decision, if you have more than two values, that is say you have around n values, or for example, if you have around five values to be identified, whichever is best, in that case, applying ID3 would be a problem. So ID3 is used only for a nominal attribute, right? It cannot handle the continuous value. So in order to overcome that particular error, they found out C4.5, where your continuous valued attribute can be converted into a nominal attribute by finding out which particular value will have the highest entropy, or by what we did is we arranged them in increasing order of their values, and we added the first value with the last value, divided by 2. That would be the nearer approximation or estimation of your splitting criteria. So based upon splitting criteria, what you can do is you can apply any of the technique. So what is our intention here? Our intention is the misclassification error should reduce. So if you compare all three in general, so this is very important. You should know this is how to select an attribute measure. So each of them is an attribute measure. Information gain is one of the attribute measure. Gain ratio is one of the attribute measure. Gini index is one of the attribute measure. So if a question is asked on attribute selection measure on decision tree, there are three measures in general. So information gain is biased towards multi-valued attribute. It is biased, but it cannot work with multi-valued attribute. Whenever you compare with respect to the multi-valued attribute, even though it is biased, the value that you get in the information gain is confusing when compared to other two methods. Gain ratio can be applied for unbalanced split. So what do you mean by unbalanced split? For example, if you are taking an continuous value, which is you require time to decide your split, that is what you mean by unbalanced split. In this, what you can do, that is the number of S and O will not be equally distributed. So that is what you mean by unbalanced split here. So whenever if you analyze your data set, if you find the number of S and O is not equally distributed, or it is unbalanced or biased towards S or no, then you can go ahead and apply your gain ratio. Gini index is very suitable for a multi-valued attribute, but Gini index would be difficult whenever you have a huge data set or a large data set, because you have to find probability of each one of them, and you have to check its probability with respect to each other attribute also, because for the first step only to find out the root node, it is easier in Gini index. But whenever you want to use the two valued attribute for the second level of your tree, you are considering two attributes. Similarly, if in our case, we got the answer in the level 2. If in case, if you don't get answer in level 2, then you have to apply it for 3 attributes, 4 attributes, so on till n minus 1 attributes. In that case, whenever your classes is large, it would be difficult to apply your Gini index. So what you have to note, whenever your data is large, you have to use either information gain or gain ratio. And one more important thing in Gini index is it will favor equi-sized partition and purity in it. It will try to maintain purity in each of the classes that it does. So this is about attribute measures. There are other attribute measures like CHIDE. So CHIDE was a decision tree algorithm which is based on chi-square test, and you have CSEP or C separator, which is better when compared to your information gain and Gini index. And there are other statistical measures like G-statistic and MDL. You should only know their names. What are the other attribute selection method? But this is not a part of your syllabus. So what you have to check is whenever there is a multivariate split based upon multiple variable combination, you will use CART method. And can you say which is the best attribute selection measure? So most of them will give the good result, but depending upon your data set, you have to find out which particular measure of decision tree is more apt, or which of them is good for your data set. That is, using the previous slide, you can decide whether you have to use information gain or gain ratio. You will go ahead and apply information gain and gain ratio whenever it is a huge data set or a large data set. So in that case, your ID3 and C4.5 is good. If it has only nominal attribute, you will go with ID3. If it has a continuous attribute also, like we have already solved for your temperature value and humidity value with values like 75, 80, like that. In that case, what you will do, you will convert that continuous value into nominal value by finding out the splitting criteria. This splitting criteria can be got by experience. So based upon that, you can find out which value has the highest entropy and take that as the splitting attribute whenever you have a large data set. But whenever you have many, what do you say, valued attribute in your decision, then you can go ahead with which method, your Gini index method. So any doubts?